I'm upset. 50,000 on my head is disrespect.
On Scorpion, Drake stings with his words and his subliminals. Let's count them up.
I've had real Philly niggas try to write my ending.
The first with Philly's Meek Mill and their infamous beef in 2015, though they seem to be friends now.
Taking shots with the gold and talking about shots that we send in.
Drake's next line could be about one of hip-hop's greats, Jay-Z. The two are also buddies now, and Hove was even featured on Talk Up, though they've traded shots over the years.
I've had scuffles with bad boys that wasn't pretending. I've had too many nights to mention, that's just the beginning.
Finally, Diddy, the founder of Bad Boy Records, allegedly got into a fight with Drake in 2014 over the song 0 to 100. These next bars seem to be dedicated to Drake's recent war and proxy war with Pusha T and Kanye, respectively.
I ain't even have to cut the tie.
We knew Drake and Kanye's relationship was rocky, but even though they collaborated on Ye, it seems their friendship is done.
Realize someone gotta die when no one are dead. Niggas gambling with their life for some content. That's the type of lottery that could get your top pick.
This line references how Drake's mentor, Jay Prince, supposedly stepped in to end the back and forth between Push and Drake, following the release of The Story of Adidon in May 2018. This is just how the album starts, and it seems the Toronto native was just getting warmed up. Drake included plenty of subs and continued on 8 out of 10, aimed at Push's accusations.
You are hiding a child, let that boy come home. Deadbeat motherfucker playing Border Patrol. Ooh! The only dead beats is whatever beats I've been rapping to. Never a matter of could I, should I, kiss my son on the forehead and kiss your ass goodbye. As luck would have it, I've settled into my role as the good guy. I guess luck is on your side.
Drake also takes shots at Yeezy's trolling leading up to the release of Ye.
Niggas pulling gimmicks cause they scared of rap, ay. Funny how they shook, ay. Got these niggas shook. Pulling back the curtain by myself, take a look, ay. I'm a bar spitter, I'm a hard hitter. Yeah, I'm light skinned, but I'm still a dark nigga. I can't even capture the feeling I had at first. Meeting all my heroes like seeing how magic works. The people I looked up to are going from bad to worse. The actions out of character even when they rehearse.
And even Kanye's outbursts on stage.
Jay-Z called me, hey bro, Jay-Z, I know you got killers. Please don't send them out my head. Just call me, talk to me like a man.
Who grips the mic and likes to kill their friends.
Next, Drake notes that he's broken the records of his icons like Jay-Z and Kanye West, but not everyone is congratulating him.
Breaking speed records on roads that these niggas paved, and they don't like that, it's written all on their face.
The Sixth God even targeted a certain radio host's skin struggles.
Like Charlamagne, I see the light and see the darkest patches.
The Weeknd may have also caught one on Elevate. Rumor has it that despite their friendship, Drake hooked up with The Weeknd's ex-girlfriend Bella Hadid after the two broke up in 2017.
I already hit her when you left her lonely. She is not the type that likes to take things slowly.
Drake has a new son, and Scorpion appears to be the end of his journey to accepting his new role as a father. When he questions the motives of a child's mother, it seems like he might be targeting his own son's mother, Sophie Brousseau.
Can't go 50-50 with no hope. Every month, I'm supposed to pay her bills and get her what she want. She not my lover like Billie Jean, but the kid is mine. Sandy used to tell me all it takes is one time, and all it took was one time. Shit, we only met two times.
From old scuffles to new beefs, Drake didn't hold back on Scorpion. What'd we miss?
Why you keep on shooting if you know that nigga dead? That's the only kind of shit that gets you some respect.
I'm Tia with Genius News, bringing you the meaning and the knowledge behind the music.